We have been talking about gasolines and of course some additives. Now it's time to check out what are those additives and what they are used for. So the most common ones are anti-knocking additives and oxygenates, fuel stabilizers, detergents and dyes. So let's start with the first ones. We have seen something on anti-knocking and why is it important to have a high octane rating and how do we add oxygenates. But technically speaking, what are they? Well, triethyl lead is no longer used, so you can forget that. MTBE, ETBE, TAMEE, those are oxygenates which increase the octane rating. The methyl terbutyl ether, ethyl terbutyl ether, and tert amyl methyl ether. Used to increase octane rating. That's essentially the main work of this. The problem with octane rating is that gasoline is directly related to its sulfur content, its octane number, and of course, the gum content and impurities. So if sulfur is fixed, and these ones are always carried on, the only thing that changes the most price of the gasolines is the octane rating. Therefore, oxygenates are very commonly used to increase the octane rating, and they are very important. Then comes fuel stabilizers. The main problem, as you know, with chemicals is that eventually with time and different pressure, oxygens and so on, there will be some reactions. So fuel stabilizers are essentially antioxidants and metal deactivators. So antioxidants are used for that, to avoid oxidation of gasoline. What you want to do is to have a fuel which can oxidize whenever you want, not as long as you have it in your storage tank. It also avoids gummy or gum sticky resins deposits result from oxidative degradation. So not only you're going to lose fuel, but you're going to have deposits, solid material, which is going to affect the performance of your automobile. The deactivators are required in order to avoid metal salts. So deactivators will actually do is sequester, or let's say to remove it from the gasoline. And this is done in order to avoid the acceleration formation of gummy residuals. Detergents, yeah, it kind of sounds like home, like you're going to be cleaning something. But what we mean with the detergents in the gasoline is essentially an additive that will reduce the internal engine carbon buildups. So technically, yes, it's cleaning the motor or avoiding, let's say, addition of carbonaceous materials. Not only that, will also improve combustion. If we have only liquids which convert into vapor and no solid is within, therefore the engine will work the better. Allows easier starting in cold climates, so that's also a good advantage. But the main goal of the detergent will always be to remove the carbon buildups. And dyes. So a dye is a color material. For instance, here gasoline and ethanol both are colorless. Well, in this specific case, it's a good idea to add, let's say, colors. So if you see something like that, you know it's not pure gasoline and not pure ethanol. If you see something like this, you can assume there is most gasoline and some ethanol. And if you see something like this, you can assume there is some gasoline and mostly ethanol. Not only that, we also use them in order to have several different fuel differentiation. For instance, in aviation gas, aviation fuels, we have the red one, which is 80. We have the green one, which is 100. And we have the colorless Jet A fuel. Okay, so that's are the main additives we add to gasoline. And of course, there are other additives used for other fuels such as diesel. Those are going to be taken charge later on.